Welcome everyone to day two of Black Cat 2017. Not as crowded today on the show floor. Some people are a little hungover, perhaps myself included. I'm here with Adam Kujawa, who hopefully is not hungover.
I'm not, but
okay.
I'll be somewhere for the both of us.
Yeah. So you're the director of malware intelligence?
Yes, I am.
For Malwarebytes.
For Malwarebytes, yeah.
So I've got some questions about the future of security. I want to talk about the future of malware with you, Adam. So what are some of the major changes you hope to see in detection technologies for endpoints and malware?
Really, the only way to go moving forward is behavioral. Mm-hmm. Using machine learning, using AI if we can, any sort of
method. You hit all three buzzwords like first thing in the morning.
I've been doing this for days. No, but seriously.
Behavior is kind of an interesting one to start with, right? Because
yeah.
I think some products will take the approach of, well, if malware like writes this file and adds this registry entry, like I'm going to look for that behavior, but it's really just a glorified signature. I know you guys aren't doing that, but I think quantify like what behavior means.
Well, yeah, what we do, we have an anti ransomware product. Mm-hmm. It's a technology included in our main product. And what it does is basically monitor all the processes, all threads, looks for any sort of operations that may be indicative of ransomware, mm-hmm. kind of creates a profile and a score for those particular operations, those API yep. calls. And if it hits a certain level, we say that's ransomware.
Okay, so it's a score-based system.
Yeah, and I mean,
and now, are you doing that analysis in the cloud or on the endpoint?
We do it on the endpoint.
Okay. And is that like a machine learning algorithm that generates the scores that what you're
yeah.
getting for?
Yeah.
Okay, that's awesome.
So yeah, I mean, that's really the future. It has to be. I don't think we should completely abandon signatures.
Right.
You know, you got to have a human element because at the end of the day, we're not fighting against robots. We're fighting against bad guys that are actual humans mm-hmm. who can pivot and be dynamic just like we can.
Right. So what are some of the challenges that we'll face specific to fighting malware in the future?
Well, it's going to get worse. I almost guarantee
users
that.
Users are going to click stuff.
They're going to click stuff. Well, that's the thing. Users are the biggest vulnerability and
they
the best
are.
Security
yeah.
For any endpoint. And the bad guys are going after. You could just look at the last 5 years and see the advanced sophistication of things like phishing and mouse spam, the use of ransomware, which in my opinion is kind of a social engineering attack because the files that get encrypted, they mean something to the users. They mean something, you know, they're not, the bad guys can't just take them and go sell them on the black market, mm-hmm. you know, so they have to get paid for that. So it's much more
against the
user. Are
you seeing an increase on ransomware on devices like phones or any kind of other IoT devices?
Oh yeah. We've seen a big increase in mobile ransomware. We see Mac ransomware all over the place these days.
Yeah.
It's still not as bad as PC ransomware, and that's never going to stop, unfortunately.
Right.
But yeah, it's getting all over the place. It's an effective method of attack.
So how will the threats evolve, in your opinion, over time, specifically like for the infection mechanisms that are used by malware?
Well, after we saw things like WannaCry and NotPetya using those SMB exploits that were released by the shadow brokers, you know, they've got more up their sleeve. We're likely to see more stuff like that where malware actually deploys the exploit technology to infect things. I think it's a whole new era for malware, and we're going to see a lot of scary stuff.
Excuse me. So how do we protect ourselves in the future, specifically with all the different kinds of technology that we use? Our cell phones, tablets, whatever the next thing is. Amazon's Echo Show, right, is an example of like the next generation of technology that we'll interact with. How do we protect those devices?
Well, I mean, for things like that, you know, it comes down to configuration. It comes down to making sure you use them correctly, using common security practices. You know, don't attach to any sort of Wi-Fi. Don't join any sort of network that you can't trust, airport networks, things like that. I mean, that's a first line of defense. That's something a user can do. Other than that, there's lots of security applications being developed to help out protect those kinds of devices. So deployment of those is also a good idea.
Awesome. Adam, thank you so much.
No problem, Paul. Thanks for having me.